gets the start in center field. Man, you're going to hear a lot about the two-hitter, the DP today, Ella Parker. An absolutely outstanding athlete, very fast. So it's not only somebody in Ella Parker that you'll see likely hitting that two-hole quite a bit, but keep an eye on her and her speed. Coach Gasso said it's not afraid to maybe use her in some stolen base situations. Parker wears number 5. She's out of Los Angeles, California, by way of Notre Dame High School. In the three-hole for the Sooners is Alyssa Brito. Brito, wow. What a season for Alyssa Brito last year. Made the shift from left field to third base and absolutely excelled. So Brito will get the start at third again here to begin the 2024 campaign, and she will bat third. In the leadoff spot is one of the Sooner co-captains in Kinsey Hansen. What an absolutely incredible season in 2024 Hansen had in her bounce-back campaign. Now, this Kinsey is one of two players on this Oklahoma Sooner roster that have played here before as Oklahoma Sooners. Riley Boone played for Oklahoma when they came here last in 2020 before the season was cut short due to COVID-19. But when Hansen was here in 2020, she went 8-for-15, drove in 8 runs, and walked once. She had 5.33 for that series. She missed the first 2 weeks of last season. She'll bat cleanup and be the catcher. In the 5-hole is T.R.A. Jennings. What more can you say about T.R.A. Jennings and her incredible career that she has had? As a matter of fact, Jada Coleman just got introduced to the crowd here, and they absolutely exploded, as they should. T.R.A. Jennings is someone that we do have on a little bit of history watch. As the next run batted in, or the next, she's at 245 for her career is T.R.A. and runs batted in. She needs 9 to tie low. Lauren Chamberlain, congratulations on getting married this past week, Lauren Chamberlain. For second on the all-time runs batted in list, T.R.A. Jennings at 245. So she'll eventually catch Lauren Chamberlain, and she'll have some work to be number one all-time in RBI and Sooner history. Man, I am really excited about the 6-hole hitter this year. She'll get the start in left field. Her name is Cassidy Pickering. She is a true freshman, so imagine you have the 3-time defending national champs, and you look at the starting lineup, and there's 2 true freshmen, and Avery Hodge is getting the start after sporadic starts last season. But let's focus here on Cassidy Pickering. Pickering, the 5'9 freshman out of Humble, Texas. Very, very popular in the travel ball scene. Had a great, great high school career. She'll get the start in left field. At first base will be Sid Sanders. The Arizona State transfer had a bit of a struggle to start the season last year, but came along and played really well in the postseason. Avery Hodge will play at second. She'll bat eighth. And in the 9-hole is the other Sooner who played in an Oklahoma uniform the last time they made the trip to Puerto Vallarta, and that was Riley Boone. And Riley Boone, I saw Gala and the entire Boone family here. I mentioned Oklahoma was rolling deep on this trip, not just with the fans, but with the family too. So the entire Boone family is out here to see Riley's final first game as an Oklahoma Sooner. But man, what a trip Riley Boone had to Puerto Vallarta back in 2020. She started the season 7-for-15, had 5 runs scored in that weekend, but then got hurt. And in fact, before the season was shut down, she was about to make her return to the starting lineup, but obviously a pandemic had other ideas. But Riley Boone back in the starting lineup. 2 straight years as a member of the All-Women's College World Series tourney team. That's a look at today's starting lineup. Presented by Norman Regional Health, building our community stronger throughout South Central Oklahoma. Today's player to watch, well, why not? Let's go with this. Patty Gasso called her the matriarch. Nicole May, she's in the circle going through her pregame warm-ups. Nicole May, what a story, too. Someone who had many opportunities if she wanted to maybe transfer, go somewhere else, become an ace, but she chose to stay here. And we'll keep an eye on the high strikeout, low walk pitcher. That is Nicole May. Loves travel stops, is the heart of the highway. I don't know what the weather is like back home. today. So I hesitate to bring you our Trails Golf Club of Norman weather report, but it is absolutely gorgeous. There's a light breeze here in Puerto Vallarta. It gets a little bit, listen, I'm not going to brag about how warm it gets here or anything, but there is actually, we heard from our buddy Dr. Kevin Klaisel, there's some concern over rain here this evening, but the two games this morning should be in good shape. Saturday looks dry as well. Temperatures will be on the warm side. It's in the mid-80s. Right now we have a very breezy, we're in the shade, 72 degrees. The Trails Golf Club in Norman, where you experience everything you love about golf and more. Well, thanks for joining us for the Sooner Softball Pregame Show presented by Walden Cleaners and Laundry. Nicole May stares in. The leadoff hitter, Benny, digs in, and the first pitch is a strike. 10:35 with the start time. We have a sun-baked field as the lefty Benny deep in the box. The slapper swings through it for strike two. Sanders even with the bag at first. Avery Hodge right in the baseline at second. Same for the shortstop, T.R.A. Jennings. And in tight at third is Booney. Or pardon me, Brito. Reached poked foul on the 0-2. Cody Thompson is the head coach of the Utah Valley Wolverines. He's in his third season. Been a struggle for Utah Valley. 18 games under 500 in his three seasons. They are looking for an opportunity to start their season by shocking the country. An 0-2 pitch. May stares in, rocks, fires, poked shallow left field. Racing in is Boone, who makes the catch right on the dirt grass cut. She was positioned perfectly. Let me tell you about that scouting job of Ryan Wondrosik and JT Gasso. Perfectly placed was Riley Boone, and there's one away.
Now batting for UVU, number 13, so, Brittany Marino.
Boone is actually getting the start in left. I thought she might see center field when we were right field when we were speculating throughout the season, but Boone is out in left, Coleman in center, and down to right field is Pickering. First pitch, and I didn't mean to, check swing by Marino is poked foul. As you might imagine, the setting here is glorious. Palm tree beyond the right center field wall. This area has grown substantially since our last trip here in 2020. Explain after the 0-1 pitch. Caught the inside edge. Strike two. The area behind the Sooner dugout, which is down the third baseline, was just kind of an open area with tennis courts, and they've enclosed that. There's a pop-up behind home plate that's going to get out of play. So instead of just an open area, they basically play kind of an outdoor version of racquetball. And now that's enclosed. It's got actually a pretty sweet, like, curved roof over the top of it. And down the first baseline, which is where they had a setup last season and when we came in 2017, that's the full flow sports setup now. 0-2. Weak grounder to the right of the circle. May gloves, shovels to first, and there's quickly two away. Has Nicole May thrown a ball yet? Two outs. Here comes Morris, the pitcher. Unbelievable start for Nicole May.
Now batting for the Wolverines. Pitcher number 22, Hallie Morris.
Hallie Morris might be a name that sounds familiar to some. She is Utah transfer. She digs in. Just underway, no score. Two up, two down for the Wolverines. First pitch for May. Morris bounces it off her foot. Foul, strike one. They've reinforced the center field wall. Thankfully, that's center field fence, I should say. They've put some green tarp around it, celebrating the Puerto Vallarta College Challenge and the flags of all the teams that are here. The 0-1. There's the first ball for Nicole May, and it comes on the third hitter. One ball, one strike. Two away here in the first. Morris deep in the box. Her left foot is actually on the chalk in her open stance. Line foul down the right side, slicing out a play. That'll rattle around. There is a massive tree in foul territory down the right field line that provides a little shade for the right fielder. Cassidy Pickering is in that. Now, there's also a couch underneath that tree. We were trying to broadcast from it. The 1-2. A little out. Two balls and two strikes. And then beyond that, a lot of Oklahoma Sooner fans. A lot. Here's the 2-2. It's popped up. Shallow center field. Late break by Jennings, who makes the catch. As Jada Coleman and Riley Boone were racing in, Coleman kind of went down and had a little laugh after watching TRA stumble a bit but still make the play. And Nicole May sets him down in order. Three up, three down in the top of the first. We head to the bottom of the first inning. Coleman, Parker, and Brito head to the plate as Oklahoma and Utah Valley are scoreless. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield.
Have lunch at Norman's favorite hidden treasure, Midway Deli, tucked away at the corner of Chautauqua and Eufaula. We may be a little hard to find, but we're even harder to forget. Midway features delicious gourmet sandwiches and a great selection of homemade soups, pastas, and stews. Whether it's lunch or catering or booking our food truck, you'll love the food from Midway. Open from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. every day. Breakfast is served all day. The Midway, serving great food to Norman since 1955.
Fowler Automotive is proud to be a part of your community, where our passion and values lie far beyond the showroom. We believe that families, sports, art, and culture are at the heart of every thriving community, and it's important to us that we help build the communities that our dealerships call home. Stop by any of our six Oklahoma dealerships to see the Fowler Standard hard at work. We pride ourselves on being friendly, helpful, honest, and fair. This is what drives us every day. Fowler Automotive, a proud partner of OU Athletics.
Do you want to avoid costly repairs for your garage door? Hey, it's Mike Steely here for Affordable Door. Most people don't think of getting their garage door tuned up once a year, but by calling Affordable Door, you can extend the life of your garage door by getting your tune-up today. Affordable Door will check the springs, rollers, and cables, plus much more. Get your tune-up today, 405-635-9499, or visit affordabledoor.net, the official garage door company of the Sooners.
Jada Coleman digs in, bottom of the first inning of a scoreless game. Here's the first pitch from Allie Morris to Jada Coleman, and it misses low and away. Ball one. Three up, three down for the Utah Valley Wolverines in the top of the first inning. Coleman leads things off in the bottom of the first by taking ball one. Here comes the 1-0. Good pitch. Caught that outside corner. One ball, one strike. What didn't Jada Coleman do last season? Absolutely unbelievable. Player of the Year candidate. Nasty little drop. Catches the inside corner. Strike two. Three-time All-American. Reigning Big 12 Player of the Year. 408 average last season. And she pops one into shallow right field. Racing over under it and making the catch. For the first out of the inning is Betancourt, the right fielder.
Lanny Betancourt with the catch and the first out. Now batting for the...
I do have some bad news, though. It has nothing to do with this team, but just a staple of our broadcast. We are going to be in a pickle for our third inning shout-outs. We have zero Wi-Fi. We had to fight, scratch, and claw to get a connection as Ella Parker takes the ball low and away. If we would have been in a position where we had to count on our hotspots today, we would probably be hearing this broadcast over Zoom or something. We would have found a way, don't get me wrong. It was not going well. As the 1-0 pitch misses outside, 2-0 to the left-handed hitting Parker. Little dinged up in fall ball early on, and then when the battle series rolled around, she just showed why she's in this opening game starting lineup. The 2-0 is low, 3-0. She is one of those players that when you watch her step on the field, you immediately know that she's got a little extra something. She takes ball four. How about that? First Sooner base runner of the season is a walk to the freshman Ella Parker. And here comes Alyssa Brito. USA Softball Player of the Year watch list, preseason All Big 12, first team preseason All American. She digs in deep in the box with Parker at first. Watch a hit and run here potentially. First pitch is a good one, strike one. They aren't playing Brito too terribly deep in center and left. Kind of surprising, to be honest. Oh, one is up high. One ball, one strike. Good job by Hereda to go up and get it, the catcher. Here's the 1-1. Swings and doesn't cheat herself on that swing. Parker was going, but she fouled it off. If there is one thing you know when you watch Alyssa Brito swing, she is definitely getting all of it, or at least getting all of it as far as how hard she's swinging. And she took a mighty hack at that. The two-strike pitch is a good one, but just misses low. Two balls, two strikes. That is the one negative here, is there is not a scoreboard in center field. 2-2. Swing and a miss. They got it. I mean, Morris pulled the chain on and off speed, and Brito swung for the fences, and here is Kinsey Hansen with two. They have a very cool hand-operated scoreboard, though, that's right behind us. I'm not going to lie. It's pretty sweet. It's old school. Here's the first pitch to Hansen. She sees and takes it low. Co-captain for the Sooners is Kinsey Hansen. Long look in by Morris. Parker hasn't shown an inkling to go yet. She's going here. Ball taken. The throw is into center field. Stolen base for Parker. Thought about. Headed to second base, but a good job in going back and actually backing up the play from Denny, the shortstop. So credit Ella Parker with the first stolen base of the season. And she's in scoring position. They called the pitch. They did call that a ball, right? So, yeah, two balls and no strikes. The pitch to Hansen. Low, ball three. I think Reddit did a good job going down and getting that. I somehow got enough of a signal to hear from Caitlin Fournier that at least the weather in Norman isn't something to where we're dealing with snow and ice and rain while we're all kicked back with our sunglasses on here in Puerto Vallarta. I would not brag, I promise. Quick trip to the circle here. Don't know if there was maybe something that Cody Thompson saw in Morris's release, but he got out there pretty quick with a full count for Kinsey Hansen. So we'll do our best. But even if we don't get to him, please know that we appreciate all the support and everyone tuned in here on the Sooner Sports Network throughout the 2024 season. All right, meeting's over. Parker's in scoring position. Scoreless game, bottom of the first. The pitch to Hansen is ball four. And here comes T.R.A. Jennings. It is an area that Oklahoma excels at. I mean, they are so good. I mean, so good at waiting for their pitch. It has been a staple of what J.T. Gasso has done with his hitters. First pitch to TRA is a good one, but missed low. The umpire kind of looked like with his shoulders that he called a strike. But that missed a little low, ball one. Here comes the 1-0 pitch with runners at first and second. That's low and away, ball two. Hanson at first, Parker at second, just underway. The pitch nearly hit her. Gets out of the way. Sooners are a pitch away here from loan the bases. Cassidy Pickering waiting on deck. Three balls and no strikes. Here's the pitch. Ball four. Oh, Morris. Get out of this first inning. Quick update to one thing that needs to be talked about more. Fale of View is back. She's coaching over at first base for the Sooners. Fale Steele, one of the coolest names ever, as here comes Pickering. First pitch, she takes for a ball outside. 23 pitches already. Just six strikes. Wow. Not a good start for Hallie Morris. Make it 24. 25 misses low inside. 25 pitches, just six strikes as Pickering is ahead on the count. Two balls and no strikes. Pickering looks like a ball player. Her mannerisms, everything about it. Has that bat balanced right on her left shoulder and takes ball three. Nods down towards the third base coach, Patty Gasso. Coach in Sooner t-shirt today. Crimson as the Sooners are in all white. 3-0 pitch. Here it comes. She hammers one. Deep to left center field. Oh, Cassidy Pickering takes a 3-0 pitch over the left center field wall. It's a grand slam. It's a grand slam home run from the freshman who goes Apo Taco. Wow, what a start. She knew that Morris would come to her. Patty Gasso gave her the green light, and Pickering drives one over the left center field wall, and Oklahoma has jumped on top 4-0. The first of many, potentially, for Cassidy Pickering. It's 4-0 Sooners, and here comes Sid Sanders. The first pitch caught the outside corner, strike one. Talk about making a statement in your first at bat. Pickering got her pitch, went with it, and drove it over the left center field wall. The 1-0 to Sanders is up high, 2-0. Well, Utah Valley also has a couple things working against them. Well, number one, you're facing the three-time defending national champs. Number two, there's a great Sooner crowd here. And number three, they're basically wearing all black uniforms. 2-1 is low. And it's starting to swelter a little bit down on the field, especially with how long they've been out there. Here's the pitch to Sanders. She rips one into left field, a base hit. Past the third baseman, Hall, in the left field. The second hit of the inning for the Sooners, and here's Avery Hodge.
Now batting second baseman, number 82, Avery Hodge.
Coach Gasso said in her press conference to start the season that Avery Hodge and Quincy Lilio and Alina Torres were locked in a good battle at second base. Hodge bunts it foul. Strike one. Hodge gets the opening day start. Opening game, I guess I should say. We'll have a second game later today between the Sooners and Duke. 1:30, the scheduled first pitch for that. The 0-1 pitch is up high, 1-1. bring it up because I think you'll see Quincy Lilio. I think you'll see Alina Torres. I think you'll see some of Brito at short, too. And there is a good, good battle ongoing at second. Hodge misses that bunt. Falls behind a ball and two strikes. Avery's got a lot of the intangibles that you want. She's fast. She can handle the bat well. Becoming a better, smoother fielder. The 1-2 pitch is low. Two balls and two strikes. Got a good personality about her, too. Not a lot of the off-season events that you would have. Avery was a part of those. She was around. 2-2, way outside, full count. Riley Boone waits on deck. Four pitches this inning for Morris. Here's the 35th. Called strike three. Now she gets two strikeouts. The Sooners strand a base runner, but the damage is done. Thanks to a freshman, Cassidy Pickering, with a grand slam home run, and Oklahoma heads to the second inning in game one of the 2024 season, leading 4-0. You're listening to Sooner Softball from Learfield. Angelique Mann will lead things off for Utah Valley, 4-0 Sooners as we head to the second. Back to work for Nicole May. Same nine in the field for the Sooners as the first one is low to the right-handed hitting man, the center fielder. Allie Boone well off the line, almost in left field, almost daring man to try to pull something off the righty May. There's a strike on the inside corner, a ball and a strike. Shallow in right field for Pickering. In fact, Cassidy has to be disappointed because JT Gasso has her position just beyond the shade tree in right field. Time called by Kinsey Hansen. She turned over to Jen Rocha and seemed to indicate something they didn't like about that call. Now we're ready. Strike on the inside corner, 1-2. That is, if you were watching Deering fall, are listening during fall, you know that we no longer have the cards, which has been, at least for the pitchers. 1-2 has popped up behind home plate. Is there room for Hansen? There is not. Kinsey gets a fresh softball. There is a... Hansen rolled it back to May. I think Nicole May wanted a little dirt on it. But the pitchers have some advice that they'll look down and coach will be able to give them the signal and where she wants it on a little digital readout as the 1-2 misses up and away. I was talking to Jen Roaches, two balls and two strikes about him. And again, we're going to talk a lot about in the early season because it's new. The pitch clock is new this year. Doesn't really seem like it's going to be in too much effect here as the 2-2 pitch is fouled off. The wild thing about the pitch clock and its enforcement is that, I mean, there's always been a pitch clock in softball. It's just it's at the umpire's discretion, which is will be for this first week. This year, it's like they'll have it more like it's been in baseball where you'll have that countdown in the outfield. Here's the 2-2, fouled off again down the right side, not a play. But the softballs are so new, I'm laughing because every time Nicole May gets a new one, the home plate umpire, he'll even help him out. He'll drop it on the ground. They're kind of kicking it around in the dirt right now, letting it get a little dirty. Get a little weathered, if you will. But in talking to Jen Roach about the new communication device for a pitcher, because it's not a walkie-talkie like they have in baseball, it's a wristband that the pitcher is essentially wearing. 2-2 is ripped right to Sid Sanders, who reaches up and makes the catch 1-1. It's different But it's a little easier. The only concern Coach Rocha was joking about how her fingers, when she has to dial in, punch in the numbers, it's a small keyboard, if you will, so she's getting used to that a little bit. That'll bring to the place a plate Megan Gibbs. First pitch, when she was swinging for the fence, was Gibbs, strike one. Just one of the many differences. Now, the players in the field, they still have their cards. Calls from coach whenever they're hitting, and, of course, defensively, so they'll be able to adjust to the pitch as the 0-1 is fouled back. But if you happen to be watching on Flow Sports, or if you watched it all, that's the band that you see around the left arm of Nicole May. The black band up her forearm. 0-2 pitch here. Foul straight back. Good cut by Gibbs. 4-0 Sooners on a first inning grand slam by Cassidy Pickering. Along with our producer Dave, back in the Franchise 2 studios, I'm Chris Plank. Thanks for hanging out with us on a gorgeous day here in Puerto Vallarta, though we don't get to brag too much. It's gorgeous in Norman and Oklahoma as well. There's a line drive right side, ranging over towards first and making the catch is Hodge. Two away. I think Sanders probably could have got that if she wanted to, but Hodge was right there, so there's two outs. And Nicole May has set down the first five that she has faced. Maya Higuerota will step in. Higuerota, the catcher.
Number three, Maya Higuerota.
Looking for six up, six down, and boy, she's painting the zone. Strike one. Sooners will get Duke later this afternoon. And then we have a nice dinner. Some of us are already thinking about it. Swing and a miss, strike two. May stands at the back of the circle, ahead on the count, no balls and two strikes. Stalks the rubber as she toes it with her right foot and stares in. The pitch, got it. Swinging on the rise, inning over. Nicole May gets her first K of the season. That's six up, six down for the Wolverines, and we head to the bottom of the second inning. It'll be Boone, Coleman, and Parker, Oklahoma 4, Utah Valley nothing. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield.
If you're looking for good times and great rewards,
Riverwind is your place to play.
With almost 3,000 of your favorite games and two table game pits in two high-stakes areas.
Celebrate the season of love with our Leap into Love giveaway.
Play to win your share of $80,000 every Friday in February.
Welcome to the best casino in the metro.
It's yoga with Drake Stoops and Kendall Daniels.
And exhale, tune into your chakras.
Yo, Drake, you feeling this yoga stuff?
Kendall, dude, I feel swonderful.
How are you so calm?
I got that Schwab swagger.
Schwab swagger?
Here, try this Schwab dog.
Mmm. Get your swag on with Schwab Meat, the official mouth-watering hot dog of OU and OSU athletics.
Namaste.
They say actions speak louder than words. So when you're trying to say, I love you, and you want it to mean more than ever, say it with a gift from B.C. Clark. From top designer jewelry brands to the finest luxury timepieces to the most spectacular natural diamonds ever unearthed, B.C. Clark is here to help you make every moment matter. Browse our extensive product lines at bcclark.com or visit one of our three Oklahoma City stores. B.C. Clark, proud sponsor of Oklahoma Athletics.
Riley Boone, the Owosso product, will lead things off for the Sooners. Oklahoma 4, Utah Valley nothing. A grand slam first inning home run by Cassidy Pickering. Back to work for Hallie Morris. 35 pitches in that first inning for Morris, and her first pitch is a strike to Riley Boone. Log on to Soonersports.com/kids for information about joining the Sooner Junior Kids Club, presented by OG&E and brought to you in part by Orthodontics exclusively, Mathis Home, and Devon Energy. There's a beautifully placed punt. There is no chance to get Riley Boone at first base as the third baseman Hall charges in and has to eat it. And the crowd chants Boone here in Puerto Vallarta, which brings Jada Coleman to the plate. Jada flying out to right field in the first. Sooner softball also brought to you by Brahms Ice Cream and Dairy Store, Farm Fresh, for over 50 years. Man, the center fielder looked into the Utah Valley dugout, asked if she needed to move over, and they kept her just straight away center field as the first pitch misses low and away to Coleman for ball one. We were talking about some of the accolades for the Sooners in 2023, and not many were able to accomplish what this senior did. Coleman grounds this one foul as Boone was off to the races. It was a little hit and run. She's among the clear career leaders for Oklahoma in on-base percentage, batting average, slugging percentage, walks drawn, runs scored. And she is 10th in program history of 49 stolen bases, and she ripped this one down the right field line foul. You hear the oohs and the ahs whenever she gets on top of one. One ball and two strikes. Been told that the deliberate nature of players like Coleman in the batter's box has been a little bit of an adjustment for him with the new pitch clock this year. 1-2 is out, two balls and two strikes. That's a good take. That's a pitch that is not only a very, very good 1-2 pitch, but a very, very good take. Here's the 2-2. Grounded right side through into right field. A base hit. Boone doesn't even hesitate on her way to third. It's first and third for the Sooners with nobody out on back-to-back hits from Boone and Coleman. And here's Ella Parker. Parker was the first base runner of the season for the Sooners when she walked back in the first inning. I say back in the first inning. Last inning. Back in the first inning. A win today for the Sooners. Up 4-0 already, looking to add to it. Would put Patty Gasso third all-time in career wins. You'd be tied. Bunt attempt, misses it. Off to second goes Coleman. The throwdown will be cut off by the second baseman, Moreno. And Boone was watching it all from a couple of steps off the bag. She heads back to third as Moreno was conceding the stolen base, but they didn't want Boone to score on that. Second and third now as the 0-1 pitch misses low and away. One ball, one strike. Don't know if you could ask for two faster players on the base paths. Coleman at second, Boone at third. The pitch is lined back up the middle, base hit. Boone will score easily. Here comes Coleman. The throw is cut off. She'll score. The throw to second is into right field from Morris. Parker will round third. She'll head home. She'll score. It's an inside the Parker home run. And Oklahoma takes it 7-0. Of course, that'll be likely a single with a throwing error. I don't want to take too much fun out of it. But the cutoff, I think it would have been close at home if they had an opportunity to let the ball go through. And we're going to have our first pitching change of the day, brought to you by Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. We'll keep it here, though. I mean, I think if, and that wasn't Morris, it was Gibbs, the first baseman, who had come over to cut it off. And when Gibbs cut it off, I think that they might have had a chance to get Jada Coleman at home. That was a heck of a throw from center field, so tell you about the new pitcher.
New pitcher in the game.
Avery Sapp will take over for Morris, who, well, I don't think it took the Sooners too terribly long to figure out what Morris is all about, and they've chased her rather quickly. So Avery Sapp immediately throws one to the backstop in her warm-up pitches. Doesn't matter, though. Parker was not done running, and she ends up touching them all after the errant throw into right center field. Boone had scored easily. Coleman, there was going to be a play at the plate, but whenever it was cut off, I mean, Gibbs, the first baseman, straight into right field. So a single, two RBI on the base hit, and that is going to be ruled the E3 that scores Parker. Well, it was fun for a moment. And the first pitch to Brito misses ball one. Parker still gets the two RBI. The 1-0 pitch misses outside, two balls and no strikes, and Oklahoma has made it 7-0. And even though it's hot, you kind of get the feeling they haven't even really broken a sweat yet. That 2-0 was a little bit up and away, but called a strike. Two balls and a strike here to Brito. A grand slam first inning home run from Pickering, a two-run single, and then scoring on the air is Parker. Weak roller down the first baseline, foul. Kenzie Hansen waits on deck as the long, lanky right-hander. Avery Sapp has taken over here. Sapp, a freshman of Spanish Fork, Utah. Spanish Fork High School, misses high. Ball three, full count, three balls and two strikes. Big, deep breath for the righty. She stares in. Rocks and fires. That ball's blasted. Deep to right center field and out of here. It didn't take long for a Brito bomb. As Alyssa leaves the yard. Hello, run rule territory. We're in the bottom of the second inning of game one, and it's 8-0 Oklahoma. A solo home run for Alyssa Brito, and she continues to not cheat herself in any swing.
Catcher number nine, Kenzie Hansen.
Here's Hansen. Walked and scored a run in the first. Here's the first pitch to Hansen. Kind of hung up high, ball one. Well, now you wonder how many innings we'll see Nicole May. Maybe one more and then get a little Kirsten deal. Here's the 1-0 pitch to Hansen. She blasts one deep to left field, and it's gone. I mean, a laser off the bat of K-9, and that got out of here in a hurry. The Sooners go back-to-back in the bottom of the second. Wow. It's 9-0 Oklahoma. I won't say the person's name, but there was somebody that said, I just don't know. Won back-to-back-to-back national titles. And you just don't know how you respond. I'm missing some big-time leadership of G3, Grace Lyons, but Oklahoma has, at least in the first inning, and now into the second, it looked like there's no rust as T.R.A. Jennings takes ball one up and away. Back-to-back home runs. Why not go back-to-back-to-back? Jennings takes it low, 2-0. Saw T.R.A.'s family here. It's good to see Nacio and Maria there front and center. The 2-0 pitch, a little off speed. That caught the inside corner, strike one. They'll be tough opponents. I mean, no offense to Utah Valley, and this game is still relatively early, but it's a great phrase. It's getting late early. Jennings waits on it and pops it foul. 9-0 here with nobody out in the second inning. So by no means are we hoisting a banner, if you will, in the second inning of game one. But you got to feel really good about the way this team has responded. Pitch. Popped foul down the left field line, hooking out of play. There's not a ton of room in foul territory down either line. This is very unique vantage point for us. In 24 being here, every other season we've been here in 17 and 20, they've had us down that right field line. So we're directly behind home plate. 2-2 misses outside. Full count. Jennings waves that bat right behind her right ear. Full count pitch. Way up, ball four. Here comes Pickering. Last time up, the lefty hit one over the left center field wall on a 3-0 pitch. They gave the Sooners a 4-0 first inning lead. They've added five more runs here in the bottom of the second inning, and they lead it 9-0. Duke coming up later this afternoon. Here's the first pitch to the freshman. Up high, ball one. You just watch mannerisms, right? Our first chance to see Cassidy Pickering in a Sooner uniform. And she looks the part. Helps when your first swing is a grand slam. Here's the 1-0 pitch that misses low and away to it. Sid Sanders waits on deck. The pitch. Ooh, layup. Full count. All right, 3-0. Pretty sure Sapp knows what happened the last time Pickering faced a 3-0 count. 9-0, though, I'm pretty sure the take side is on, and it is, and it's a strike. Three balls and one strike. Pop foul down the left side. Pickering waited on the off speed and poked it down the left field line. And now the count is full. Done a nice job here with the area around it, too. Talk about that in a bit. That one's bounced to second. Moreno tried to tag Jennings. Did she get her? Yes. Throws to first. Double play. Utah Valley starts to run off the field, but it's only the second out of the inning. Nice play by Moreno. She tagged out, charging the ball, Jennings, and then threw to first to get Pickering. And here's Sanders with two away. Pickering stops for a quick debrief with Avery Hodge before hitting the Sooner dugout. First pitch to Sanders, nearly hit her, ball one. After the Pickering home run in the first, Sanders followed it up with a single. She was stranded, though, after Hodge struck out to end the first inning. And she pops one, shallow left center field. Racing in is Hawker, who makes a play. Hawker makes the catch, and that'll do it for the Sooners in the second. But the damage is absolutely magnificent. Five more runs for the Sooners. Back-to-back home runs from Brito and Hansen. And as we head to the third, it's all Oklahoma. They lead it 9-0. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. With Oklahoma rolling 9-0 over Utah Valley. Back to work is Nicole May. First pitch is blown away for ball one. You are not going to believe this, but our man Thomas, the new media relations director, just absolutely saved the day for the third inning shoutouts. Thomas, you are everyone's favorite. 9-0 Sooner as the pitch is in for a strike. As Dave was getting a kick, Dave is our producer over at the franchise. And he's right. Every pitch is either way out of here or strike three. And that's how it's been to start this game. Speaking of strikes, there's a strike. Nine runs for the Sooners by my count. Don't tell me, Thomas. Don't tell me. Seven hits that we got. Look at me. There's a line shot foul. That's the hardest hit ball they've had so far today. Good to see Brooke is tuned in. Those are our third inning shout outs. The best way to get in touch with the show is at OU on the air. That's at OU on the air. I say the show, the game, the broadcast. Though it's been like a show so far with these bats. There's a ball that just misses outside. It was the first little bit of adversity that Nicole May has had, and it's a two-ball, two-strike count. That's saying something about how good she's been so far. Here's this 2-2, and it's line foul. 13 shout-outs, by the way, are brought to you by Century Roofing. Century Roofing is on guard for Oklahoma. Gabby is the newest member of the Sooner staff. She's been stuck sitting next to me the whole time. I feel terrible. Who is this crazy man? Screaming and yelling in a 9-0 game. Here's the pitch. Ground ball right to third. Brito, smooth, laser over to first, one away. Pete is tuned in today in Berlin, Connecticut. Had a friend that wanted to make sure that you're appreciated, Pete. Doug down in Texas, Zana and Jana checking in from the Cancer Treatment Center in North Huntington, Pennsylvania. We've been praying for your mom, Jana. Hope things are going well. First pitch swinging, fouled back from Hall. That moment when you suddenly get all the service. It's the most amazing thing ever. There's a line drive to right field, caught. Nice job by Pickering. Ranged in and made the catch, and there's quickly two away for Bettenker.
And out number two. Next up for the Wolverines, right fielder, number two, Lainey Bettenker.
And here's the nine-hole hitter, eight up, eight down. First pitch, strike. I mean, there is no doubt about Nicole May just pounding the zone here today. I mean, it has been fantastic. There's a bouncer back up the middle, cut off, no. Hodge deep at second, can't make the play. Nine-hole hitter is the first base hit of the game, and Bettencourt is on for Benny. Most Sooners checked in while teaching first grade PE. Cowboy Sooners synced up in Aberdeen, South Dakota. Big Zill and Ada.
Now batting for Utah Valley, the shortstop, number eight.
Tiffany Watts is tuned in from Muskogee. John and Robin synced up in Ada. Dodger Blaine out in Arizona. Cindy Coleman, Tommy and Cindy at Air Park in Arkansas. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Almost looked like she was just trying to get on top of it. Mark Worley checked in early. Larissa Holquin. Good to see our buddy Stephen York. Matt Davis. Look at this. The pitch. Fouled off. Jessica Baim and Brooke Looper were actually the first two that checked in today. That's the most important thing that happened. Very first in. Foul ball looked like it might have took a shot off of Kinsey Hansen's foot, so they're going to give her a second to walk it off as our home plate umpire is out with her right now. And they'll jog back in. That's a good sign. Back to action. Here's the pitch. Pop foul, left field, foul territory. Boone gives chase, comes up just short. Number one, Oklahoma Sooners. Preseason across the board. Squaring off against Utah Valley, and what a start. 9-0 OU, the pitch, swing and a miss. Inning over, Nicole May gets the strikeout after allowing her first hit of the season. Dallas checked in. Danny Harrelson is tuned in. The OU Duckster, Judy's in New Mexico. Jimmy is in Duncan. And as always, Kyle Davis tuned in as you're listening to Sooner Softball. We head to the third. It's Oklahoma on top, 9-0. Bottom of the third coming up next. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield.
Hi, I'm Mike Rowe, and I was surprised to learn the people of Oklahoma Oil and Natural Gas have voluntarily cleaned up over 19,000 well sites. Some were abandoned 50 years ago by their original owners. Some over 100 years ago. While your friends and neighbors in the energy business are spending tens of millions of dollars every year on well cleanup and land restoration, not because they have to, because it's the right thing to do. Hear the full story at oerb.com/micro.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever?
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must try for... Aw, Jim!
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
We're still on the air.
When it comes to savings on Ford trucks, get more from Bob Moore Ford. Right now, take $12,000 off MSRP. Plus, get 1.9% financing on a brand new 23 Ford F-150 XLT. And right now, Bob Moore Ford has over 170 new Ford trucks to choose from. Don't miss your opportunity to save big by taking $12,000 off a new 23 Ford F-150 XLT. Bob Moore Ford, I-35 and Southeast 89th Street, or bobmooreford.com. Stock numbers 4158-5010.
Hannah Kaur is going to lead things off for the Sooners. She'll pinch it here for Avery Hodge. Hannah Kaur had herself a heck of a spring. Well, that doesn't make any sense. We're headed towards spring. Hannah Kaur had herself a heck of a fall. And she'll get a chance to bat here with Oklahoma firmly in control, leading 9-0 here in the bottom of the third inning. Here's the first pitch to the right-handed hitting Sooner outfielder. Liz missed a majority of last year with a back injury. She swings through it for strike one. But oh, what a fall she had. Shown off some power that maybe was a little bit unexpected too as she swings and fouls that one straight back. Nine runs for the Sooners, seven hits, had three home runs. Not too bad. Pitch, hitter on the elbow. And Cora will reach on the hit by pitch. And that'll bring another pinch hitter for the Sooners to the plate in Alina Torres. Patty Gasso had checked both in.
Oklahoma, number 40, Alina Torres.
Josh has checked in from work in Hennessy. OU Architect listening while in a Zoom call. True Sooner delivering mail. Well, Alan is listening in Boyne City, Michigan today. First pitch is a strike to Alina Torres. Torres saw time mostly in the outfield last year, but it's more of an infielder by nature. She takes the 0-1 pitch outside for ball one. One ball, one strike. Of course, speedy at first, but I doubt you'll see much with OU up 9-0 here. Torres takes ball two. That hung up a little bit high. Two balls and a strike to Alina Torres. pitch. Low ball three. Torres out of Glendale, Arizona, the senior. Extra year of eligibility here. Take strike two, full count. So those seniors for the Sooners who have that extra year, Boone, Hansen, Maxwell, Torres, who rips this one foul. Look out, Coach Gasso. Riley Ludlam, Kelly Maxwell. Oh, God, Carly Keeney, too. Have you heard Coach of the pregame show? She said expect to see some Carly Keeney here this afternoon. I'm excited. We didn't get a chance to see Keeney in the fall at all because she got hurt. Rip, base hit off the glove of the shortstop, Benny, into shallow left field. Core doesn't slow down. She's off to third. Torres takes second. Wow. No stopping the Sooners when they get them going on the bases like that. And it's second and third for Jada Coleman. With nobody out here in the third, People of Oklahoma Oil and Natural Gas are on the job 24/7, producing the energy to fuel modern life. They're also voluntarily restoring thousands of acres of land, over 20,000 orphan wells to date, plus contributing millions to our state schools each year. Hear all their stories at oerb.com/micro. Here's Jada. First pitch. Well, that looked a little low. Called a strike. We will not complain with a 9-0 lead and runners at second and third. That would just be rude. The pitch just missed. One ball, one strike. Sooners will have a quick turnaround before Duke. Duke's here. They're watching part of the game in left center field as the 1-1 pitch was a little bit out, but called a strike. I don't know if you could tell or not, but the fans here did not like that. The 1-2 reaches, pops it up. On the infield, is there room for Hall to make the play? No. Actually hits on top of the dugout. Might have caught a break there. Jada flying out to right in her first at bat, singled, stole a base, and scored a run in the second. 1-for-2 without a run score. The pitch, foul straight back, and I jump. I'm not even going to lie, I jump. It scared me. Jump back, I don't think I was the only one. That thing was rocketing straight back. The pitch reaches again and pokes it foul. Boy, that is one thing about these hitters. I'm sure if you've watched or listened long enough, you can tell when the zone is expanded or a pitch is called a strike that they might typically take. They'll do what they can to protect the plate like Coleman did there. The two-strike pitch waits on it, grounds it down the first baseline fair. Into right field, four scores easily. Here comes Torres. She'll score, sliding in safely for a double. A two-run double at off the bat of Jada Coleman has made it now 11-0 Sooners. A two-hit day for Jada Coleman. A stolen base, a run scored, a couple of runs batted in, and here's Ella Parker.
Next up for the Sooners, number 5, Ella Parker.
First pitch, swing and a miss, strike one. I mean, she took a monster swing. Parker on the day has reached both times, walked in the first, stole a base and scored a run, singled and scored a run in the second, though it ended up being an inside the park home run as that pitch just misses inside. The throw into home on her two-run single was cut off by the first baseman Gibbs, who launched it into right field. A pitch misses low and away. Two balls and a strike. Two balls and one strike. There we go. Home plate umpire has been good to us. making sure we are updated on the count without the scoreboard. 3-1 as that off-speed misses. Parker waits. Coleman at second. Sooner is in control here. The pitch, ball four. Ella Parker, in her first regular season game in a Sooner uniform, has reached base all three times. Jennifer's tuned in Vegas. Bob and Pat are out in El Dorado Hills. Joanne tuned in today. As soon as, oh, True Sooner delivering mail in Yukon. How can I ever forget True? As soon as I mentioned how great the Wi-Fi was, it stopped. It's my luck this weekend so far, guys. Brito homered her last time up. Here's the first pitch. Takes it low and in, ball one. The runner at first is Parker. The runner at second is Coleman. She takes the 1-0 high, two balls and no strikes. Tracy's in Chickasha. Tim's tuned in Bridgeport. Dan Lee is in Hastings, Florida. CD's also in Hockley, Texas, as the 2-0 misses. Doug, you might have a bunch of people in Hockley there. You need to get a watch party together. Granny Karen and Papa Noain tuned in Orlando, Florida. Let's go. The pitch. Ball four. And the bases are loaded for Kinsey Hansen's spot, but we will not see Kinsey Hansen. As Patty Gasso will go to the bench here. And it's honestly one of the coolest stories that Coach Gasso has talked about, and that is when she decided to give Riley a scholarship. The phone call that was made was amazing. Riley Ludlum was from Furman, and when Patty Gasso called her, she didn't believe that it was Patty Gasso calling her. First pitch to Ludlum. A little bit low and away, ball one. In fact, Coach joked to the coaches luncheon that she kind of started to hyperventilate a little bit. 1-0 pitch misses inside. Oh, that caught the corner. One ball, one strike. Okay. Zone is expanded here, and that's to be expected when it's 11-0. Pitch. Off speed misses low, 2-1. Ludlum again had a really nice fall. Shown she belongs here. She lifts one to left field, shallow left field, racing over in foul territory, and making the catch is Hawker. It'll score a run because Coleman will tag. And a sac fly RBI for Riley Ludlum has given the Sooners yet another run. Now 12-0 Sooners.
Shortstop number 23, T.R.A. Jennings.
T.R.A. Jennings steps in. My stat sheet has T.R.A. with two walks and time is called. Brito's at first. Parker is at second. The home plate umpire is saying, oh, we're going to have a pitching change. T.R.A. Jennings had turned to the home plate umpire and they'd said something, but then you look out and we're going to get our second Love's Travel Stops pitching change of the day. We'll go ahead and keep it here. As it's like, what, 50? Well, this is a unique pitching style. 52 will be the new pitcher. And this is as unique of approach as I've seen. Cam Davis, when she was going through her early warm-ups, let's see if it's she started her motion literally, yeah, she's got her left leg almost on the ground as she starts. So Cam Davis will replace Sapp. She'll be the third pitcher of the day for the Sooners. As Oklahoma is on top 12-0. And looking to add more after the sack fly from Ludlam. Jennings, Pickering, and Sid Sanders are the next three slated for the Sooners. We'll see what Patty Gasso might have as far as digging into her bench a little bit. When you can't be at the game, Sooner Sports TV has you covered on the air and online at Soonersports.tv. Sooner Sports TV presented by our cornerstone partners, Anheuser-Busch and OU Health. And Orthodontics exclusively is proud to sponsor the Junior Captain of the game. Junior Captain is the ultimate fan experience for children 6 through 12. There are two locations in Norman and South Oklahoma City, and every consultation is free. Boomer. Bob Moore Ford is proud to honor service members to the Patriot of the game. To nominate a Patriot, visit BobMooreFord.com/hero. All right, here we go. T.R.A. Jennings steps to the plate. First and second. One out. Hannah Cora pinch hit, was hit by a pitch to start the inning. Alina Torres then singled. A double by Coleman. A walk to Parker. A walk to Brito. And the sack fly. There's a ball in the dirt. Good job by Higuereta to get in front of it and block it. Morris out of Tucson, Arizona, a Utah State transfer, takes or watches her 1-0 pitch, misses low and away, 2-0. As unique of an approach as I've seen, that left knee almost all the way to the ground as Jennings takes ball 3 low and in. Parker's at second, Brito's at first. No, you looking to add to its 12-zip lead. Sooners will at the very least have one more at bat after this inning, but there's only one out here. There's a strike. Davis kind of straightening up a little bit more. The pitch nearly hit her. Ball 4. Off the first goes Jennings. And looky here. The bases are loaded again for Cassidy Pickering. The last time she batted with the bases loaded was in the first, and she drove one over the left center field wall. First pitch, way outside, ball 1. Here's the 1-0 pitch. That's a strike. 1-1. Parker at third. Brito at second. TRA over at first. One-one in the dirt to the backstop, but Parker's going to stay at third. Now, I don't know if in a close game she would go either. There's just not a lot of room behind home plate. Really not. Knowing Coach Gasso, she would send her. But it'd be tough to score on that. Pickering lifts this one to left field. Not quite deep enough. As over to catch it is Hawker. Parker will tag for third and come home with a lucky number 13th run of the game. Not a bad debut for Cassidy Pickering. 1-for-2 with 5 runs batted in. And here's Sydney Sanders. Oh, Quincy Lilio will pinch it. So we've seen Ludlam, Q, Hannah Core, and Alina Torres off the bench for the Sooners. Here's the first pitch to Q with runners at first and second now and 2 outs. Misses low and away. A 4-run first, a 5-run second, and now a 4-run third. And it's 13-0 Sooners. Lilio also represents the ninth batter this inning. The Sooners, as she takes the ball. Sooners have yet to hit a round in this game. Wild. They've sent nine batters to the plate in each of the first three innings. And there is a strike. That's kind of wild. 13 runs in three innings. Well, 2 2/3 at least now as that pitch misses low and away. I say that, and we're a ball away from it happening for the first time here to Lilio, who showed off some pop last season. Here's the pitch. Ooh, it hit her. Base is loaded. How do you score that? Hit by pitch? It was ball three anyway. All right.
Now batting for the Sooners.
Q, by the way, looks to be okay. And on cue, Oklahoma has batted around here in the third. Dims the rules, right, T-Row? You got to officially have a 10th person come to the plate to bat around, and Core takes ball one low and in. Core had pinch hit to lead this inning off, and she was hit by a pitch as well. This is Avery Hodges' spot. Hodge went 0-for-1 today with a strikeout. See if she re-enters at second base or not. There's a line drive to right field, but in good position is Buttoncore to make the catch, and that'll do it. Inning over. But Oklahoma adds to its already impressive lead, and as we head to the fourth, it's Oklahoma 13, Utah Valley nothing. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Change in the circle. Love's travel stops the heart of the highway. It'll be Kirsten Deal who will take over. Saw Kirsten's mom here enjoying her daughter getting an opportunity to pitch in the opener. Let's see what other changes we have. It's like Alina Torres will stay in the game and play second base. And Riley Ludlam is in behind the plate. So K-9 gets a little bit of a break. Core is out in left field for a Boone. And Torres is at second. Here's a bunt down the first base line, fielded by Deal. The throw is not in time. Moreno, who leads things off with a single, the second hit of the game. The line for Nicole May, workmanlike. Three innings, just one hit. Struck out two, didn't walk a batter. Set down the first eight batters she faced. It was Hallie Morris. Morris got the start in the circle, didn't quite make it out of the second. As the first pitch from Deal is up high. Deal face mask, shades, spins the ball in her left hand as she gets set for the 1-0 pitch to Morris, who's 0-for-1 with a pop out to short. There's a strike, good pitch. That has some juice on it. So new look infield for the Sooners, Ludlam behind the plate. Ella Parker's now in at first base, too. Didn't even notice that. New right side with Torres at second. And that's popped up. Shallow center field. Coleman races in. Couldn't find it. Missed it. The ball dropped in front of her. Tried to get the runner advancing to second, but the throw just got away from T.R.A. Jennings, and that looks like it might be an error on the Sooners. Jada Coleman looked up, and when she looked up, she saw the sun. They're going to give her a hit. And Utah Valley's got a little something going here in the fourth, but it is all Sooners, 13-0 Oklahoma. And they're going to have a pinch runner over at first base for Morris. They are going to give Morris a hit. Taylor Wooten, who's actually playing through an injury, she's their flex. She's going to go ahead and pinch run here. Good opportunity for Kirsten Deal to face a little bit of adversity. See how she handles it.
Pinch runner in at first base, number 9, Taylor Wooten. Now batting.
Wooten was listed as a flex, even though they essentially told us that she's probably not going to play for a while. She's got an injured hand, as a cast on her right hand, as the first pitch is low and away, ball one. Wooten broke her thumb. Has that blue cast on her right hand, but getting an opportunity to pinch run here. First and second. Nobody out. Deals. 1-0 pitch is popped up. Another sky-high pop-up on the infield. Jennings, though, has a beat on this one, makes the catch, and that's one away. I think in most normal situations when Coleman was struggling, Torres seemed a little bit unsure on that pop-up to center field, shallow center field, too. It was dying fast. Maybe that's typically a play you like to see your second baseman get out there and make. First pitch misses up and away, ball one. But that is definitely, as Aaron Miller once had told us, a high sky today. That sun is bearing down here in Puerto Vallarta. Here's the 1-0 pitch from the Sooner lefty. That's a really good spot. Called a ball 2-0. I mean, that is a really good spot. Two balls and no strikes. 13 runs for the Sooners. 9 hits. There's a line drive to right field. It falls for a base hit. The runner will be held at third, and the bases are loaded. Good job by Ludlam behind home plate to block the throw from right. Pickering's throw is a little bit short. And the bases are loaded for Maya Higuerata. It looks like Rachel Brown is going to hit here. So Higuerata's day is done, and Rachel Brown will step in. Oh, what an opportunity. Bases are loaded. First pitch to Brown. A little bit out, ball one. I'm telling you what, Nicole May was great. Kirsten Deal is not missing by much here. That ball was just off the outer edge. Here's the 1-0 pitch from Deal. That's a strike. One ball. That was called a ball. Two balls and no strikes. And Jen Roach immediately pops out of the Sooner dugout. And she's going to go have a quick word with her young lefty. Patty Gasso referred to Kirsten Deal as the future for Oklahoma in the circle and getting an opportunity here early. The University of Oklahoma and Sooner Sports Properties would like to thank our concession partners, Anheuser-Busch, Fletcher's Original Corny Dogs, Nashbird, Coca-Cola, The Baked Bear, Community Coffee, Taco Mayo, Boomerang Diner, Schwab Meat, and Uber Eats. And did you know the Oklahoma Medical Research Foundation has more than 300 researchers working daily to combat Alzheimer's, autoimmune disorders, cancer, and heart disease? Learn more about Oklahoma's Medical Research Foundation at omrf.org. All right, the meeting and the circle is over. As Brown digs in. First and third. First, second, and third base is loaded. The no Fumar sign blocked the runner at second. There's a foul ball straight back. That came off the bat awkwardly, if you will. There's a massive metal sign that says no Fumar. And it could not be placed more perfectly than right over the runner at second. 2-1, swing and a miss, strike two. She just reared back and threw it right by her. Whatever Jen Rocha said worked. One out, top of the fourth, 13-0 Sooner, swing and a miss. Deal got her swinging, and there's two away. There's a left fielder, Hawker. Well, nope, it's not. We're going to see a pinch hitter here. We're going to go to the bench and bring in Amber Rodriguez to pinch hit here.
Pinch hitter at bat for the Wolverines, number one, Amber Rodriguez.
Rodriguez, a freshman out of Covina, California, by way of Northview High School. We'll get an opportunity here. First pitch, the lefty grounds it to third. Brito up with it, throws to first. Got it. Inning over. The best threat of the day for Utah Valley goes by the wayside. Three hits, no runs. Three runners left on base. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Likely the last time we'll see the Sooners hit today. This morning. Oklahoma leads at 13 to nothing. This is Sooner softball from Learfield.
Phillips 66 and Conoco are there for those who never stop going, like Mike, before a first date.
Ready, set, go! Oh, no! Why did I eat spaghetti right before my date with Samantha? This sauce is never coming out. That's okay. This is why you left an hour early. I'll just run home. Here's a shirt, but wait, it's bedazzled. Where did I even get this? Yes, finally a clean button down. Really? Another red light? Okay, parking and running, and here's my movie ticket, and... whew. Just in time.
There's go in everything you do. Phillips 66 and Conoco are there to fuel all the ways you go, go, go.
The Whataburger Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit is back. But some folks have yet to try it. So let's not do the thing where we're like, you've never had a jalapeno cheddar biscuit before? You know what? It's okay. Let's just invite them to try this flaky, cheesy, and slightly spicy goodness for themselves. The Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit, available as a sandwich or on its own from 11 p.m. to 11 a.m. for a limited time at participating locations. Whataburger, just like you like it.
Fowler Automotive is proud to be a part of your community, where our passion and values lie far beyond the showroom. We believe that families, sports, art, and culture are at the heart of every thriving community, and it's important to us that we help build the communities that our dealerships call home. Stop by any of our six Oklahoma dealerships to see the Fowler standard hard at work. We pride ourselves on being friendly, helpful, honest, and fair. This is what drives us every day. Fowler Automotive, a proud partner of OU Athletics.
We'd like to thank our OU Community Outreach partners, Fowler Auto Group, OU Health, OG&E, and Coca-Cola. The University of Oklahoma Athletics is one with you. And Love's Travel Stops, the presenting sponsor of OU Softball. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. First pitch to Alina Torres is up and away for ball one. Another pitching change, fourth pitcher of the day for Utah Valley, is first lefty that the Sooners have seen today, as Paige Armendariz finds the strike zone. One ball and one strike. As unique of a spelling, I think, as we've seen of a name. 1-1 misses up high. Armendariz. But P-A-Y-G-E for Paige. Discuss amongst yourselves. 2-1 misses low, ball three. I kind of feel like Paige is a P-A-I-G-E. Don't see a lot of Y's. Torres digs back in. She pinch hit, played second last inning, had a single score to run. That's high for ball four. Well, one thing is guaranteed, the Sooners are going to have a runner in every inning when they hit this game. 13 to nothing Sooners. It's going through the walks. I think that's walk or free pass number 10 for Oklahoma. Here's the first pitch to Jada Coleman. That's way inside, ball one. Jada on the day is 2 for 3, has scored a couple of runs, stole a base. She's off to a nice start for her 2024 campaign. The pitch, low, 2 balls and no strikes. 17 home runs last year, matched her career total. from her first two seasons. She takes strike one. Her first home run in 2023 didn't come until the 13th game of the season. It was against Loyola Marymount in the Marion Utter Classic. She then proceeded to home run four straight games in five of six. And she loops one to the left field. It's caught. Hawker, who did re-enter the game, comes in, makes the catch, and there's one away. Ooh, she hit that hard.
Amber Rodriguez with the catch and the first out.
Job by our PA guy. Rodriguez stayed in the game and is out in left field for Utah Valley. That'll bring Ella Parker to the plate. She's reached each time she's been to the plate. Two walks and a single. Has driven in a couple of runs. Scored all three times. She takes strike one. Under first is Torres. She reached on a walk. A four-run first, a five-run second, a four-run third. 13-0. The next pitch misses low and in. Competition ratchets up a bit with Duke looming next. Off speed, that was a beauty. Call to strike. Telegraphed maybe just a bit from Paige. Parker waits, here it comes. Swing and a miss. Got her swing. Two away. And here comes Alyssa Brito, trying to help the Sooners avoid its first scoreless inning.
Now batting for the Sooners, third base
for today.
Alyssa Brito.
Brito has had herself a start to the season. Hit a home run. Now lines this one off the glove of the second baseman. Is there time to get her at first? They're going to say they got her. Moreno had it pop off her glove at second as she chased it down and threw it to first. There was a small collision between Brito and Gibbs. Both were okay, and Gibbs stayed on the bag, and the Sooners, after the leadoff walk, go in order. Hit a couple balls hard, but a scoreless fourth. And as we head to the fifth, OU three outs away from continuing the streak. It's Oklahoma 13. Utah Valley nothing. And we're going to see a new pitcher. Peyton Monticelli will be in to close it out for the Sooners when we come back. Hall, Betancourt, and Binney. 8-9-1 hitters will face Peyton Monticelli as the Sooners make a pitching change. Brought to you by Love's Travel Stops. Love's Travel Stops is the heart of the highway. Monticelli, the transfer from Wisconsin, high praise. A lot of buzz around the stuff that she brings to Norman. First pitch is popped foul behind home plate. That's not the only change for the Sooners. Back in at second base is Avery Hodge. Ludlam stays behind the plate. Pickering in right, Coleman in center, and back out in left field is Riley Boone. Riley just thought that she was done for the day. Here's the 0-1 pitch from the righty Monticelli. Swing and a miss, strike two. And you can see it. She let out a bark on that one. She's got a quick motion. I didn't get to bug Jen Rocha too much for our scouting reports. We'll do that for the games tomorrow on these new pitches. Here's the 0-2. Foul straight back. But from what we learned in the fall now into the spring, if there is one thing that is for certain about what Monticelli can bring, she can flat out bring the gas. She throws hard. Here's the 0-2 pitch again for Monticelli. Popped up right side. Is there room for Parker? There is, in foul territory. She makes the catch up against the fence, and there's one away here in the fifth. 13-0 Sooners in complete control. Duke coming up next. It looks like we're going to see another pinch hitter in Betancourt's spot. It's Cody Thompson. He's doing what he can to get as many of his players at bat here against the champs. Sage Nielsen. 25, yep. So she'll hit here. Two outs in the fifth.
For Utah Valley, pinch hitter number 25, Sage Nielsen.
The nine hole in this lineup has one of the four Utah Valley hits. The pitch. Oh, my goodness. Swing and a miss. Strike one. And Monticelli absolutely rocked that right by her. Here's the 0-1. Strike two. We don't have, like, an official gun, but that one was right at 66. Just saying. No balls and two strikes. Monticelli popped up. On the infield is their room. Brito's calling off everyone and makes the catch. She makes the catch in foul territory, and there's two away. And Emma Haygood will be the last hope here for Utah Valley with the Sooners up 13. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one, 65. No balls and a strike. Monticelli. Rocks and fires. Just missed inside. I mean, just missed. One ball, one strike. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. The Sooner fans here, clap is one. Monticelli stares in. The pitch, just a little bit up. Two balls and two strikes. There are a lot of Sooner fans here. Two balls, two strikes. Aiden. Got her. Swinging ball game. Win column Sooners. Oklahoma in run rule fashion makes an emphatic statement to start the 2024 season with a 13-0 win over Utah Valley. Add another to now a 54-game winning streak, and Patty Gasso moves into third in the all-time wins list as Oklahoma starts the season 1-0 with a 13-0 win over Utah Valley. We'll do a quick Bud Light post-game show when we come back. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield.